Hi, everybody. The time's 9:23. We appreciate you watching Minnesota Live. You may have seen some monarch butterflies outside this last week. Mm-hmm. That is, just to be clear, that is not normal for this time of year.
So monarch butterflies are taking longer to migrate. They should be on their way to Mexico, Viva la Mexico, right now. But they're taking their time. Rita Morris is the outreach coordinator for Monarch Joint Venture, and she's here to tell us more about the monarch butterfly migration and then why some butterflies are still lingering. Rita, it's so nice to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
I mean, I get it. It's been warm and beautiful, but let's start with the abnormality of this season. What are you all seeing this season that's different from what you normally expect from monarchs?
Yeah, so monarchs would typically be out of Minnesota by like the first or second week of September.
Wow.
So the fact that they're still here is very abnormal. And it's been a really warm September, the hottest on record. Mm-hmm. So that's really confused the monarchs, and it's caused the milkweed to stay healthy and alive when normally it would die back by now. And that's a cue for monarchs that they should be heading out to Mexico.
You know, that's funny you bring that up, because I just was going by my neighbor's house and she's got like a whole beautiful monarch habitat with like hundreds of milkweed. And I did notice the milkweed, and we've been hearing from people that like the lilac trees are reblooming, and it just
mine did.
It just a super weird when you talk about the flora that's around.
Yeah, and it's really important to plant for monarchs. And I've noticed some double blooms happening because of this really strange weather that we've been having this whole summer, honestly.
So what does this mean then if they're here longer? Is this going to disrupt their migration, or will they eventually go where they're supposed to go?
They should be migrating right now to Mexico, to their overwintering grounds in central Mexico in the mountains. Mm-hmm. It's hard to say what this will result in. Ideally, they'd be migrating earlier because they would still have those floral resources to feed on and fuel themselves as they're migrating.
I see.
But hopefully there's still things blooming along the way.
Sure.
Yeah.
So tell us about the life cycle of the monarch. Like, let's go back to basics. Yeah. What's their normal, you know, we love to watch them, and we will raise them in the yard with the kids. It's so fun.
Yeah. So their life cycle is a little bit complicated. So I can just start from the egg to the caterpillar, to the pupa, which is the chrysalis, a closing and the adult coming out, that takes about a month.
Okay.
But then as an adult butterfly, that varies if it's a summer generation or a migratory generation. So a summer generation lives about a month, give or take a couple weeks.
Wow.
And they're just eating and breeding.
Yeah.
And there's a few generations that will happen here in the summer. And the migratory generation is the one that can live a really long time. So they live 6 to 9 months.
So you're in the migratory generation purely based on when you're born, if you're a monarch butterfly.
Yes.
I did not know that.
Yeah, I didn't either. I was just trying to figure it out. I was like, are they breeding along the way as they go south? But no, some just live longer.
Yeah. So if they are born in around August, those ones will be the migratory generation.
And that's the one then that we're really relying on them, because they have to go south and then they have to make it back in order to continue to breed and keep the life cycle. Because no monarch butterfly is surviving our Minnesota winter.
No, unfortunately not. Yeah, right. So they have to make it down to Mexico and overwinter there, and they'll start making their way back up north and make it to like southern Texas and start breeding there, and their offspring will continue the journey back up north.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
I got it.
So the grandchildren are the eggs and caterpillars that you're first seeing here. Those are the grandchildren of the monarchs that were in Mexico.
Fascinating.
It is fascinating.
So I like to equate it to human terms.
If they wouldn't get to Mexico?
So what would happen if they didn't?
Yeah.
That would not.
Like, what if things stayed? What if things stayed warm enough up here? You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, I think that'd be unlikely for quite a while.
Gotcha.
Because it needs to be above 55 degrees for them to be able to fly.
How long does it take them to get to Mexico? Like, are they on a Sun Country flight? Yeah, I'm sorry, just had to joke. How long does it take them to fly?
That would be nice for them.
It's 4 hours.
Yeah, a couple months around there. Because if they're leaving when they should be in August, they should be arriving in their overwintering grounds around the Day of the Dead.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So, all right, your eyes really lit up when Chris talked about his neighbor who has the milkweed, you know, and so immediately I started thinking, Rita wants more people to support the life of the monarch. So what can we do in our yards or maybe even in the things that we're purchasing to make sure that we are contributing to plants that make a difference for the monarchs?
Yeah, absolutely. A big thing is reducing your pesticide usage or just stopping. That's awesome to do, and that will help all pollinators, not just monarchs. But planting native milkweed. There's 14 species that are native to Minnesota, so there's a lot of options.
And it's beautiful.
It is beautiful.
It grows tall. Yeah, it's like so nice in your yard.
Comes in so many colors.
Yeah.
Smells great, too. A lot of things will visit it. And planting other native plants is also really important because we need that diversity of bloom time because the adults are eating the flower nectar. They're not eating the milkweed, which is the host plant for their caterpillars. It's essential for their life cycle. But planting everything.
So can you just go? Somebody gave us a milkweed plant, and unfortunately it died. It didn't get a chance.
That's okay. You can have another chance.
Can you like just go to the garden center and buy milkweed seeds?
Yes, you can. We actually have a milkweed and vendor map on our website,
monarchjointventure.org,
and those are all verified, cleared vendors. Mm-hmm. So they are pesticide free, and they are also selling the native species.
Okay. I love seeing, you know, like my local garden center, I go to Mother Earth Gardens in Minneapolis, and they have a whole section that says native plants. And I find that to be kind of just, I'm just like, all right, that's what we're doing.
Right.
Because I don't want to mess around with anything else that I'm trying to keep alive.
And it's so much easier.
Yes.
It takes a lot less water once they're established, and they're beautiful. They'll keep coming back year after year.
Okay, this is great. Rita, thank you so much.
Yeah, Rita, nice to meet you.
So
thank you.
So fun to chat with you. The migratory, they're just born at a certain time. Who knew? So we've got more information about Monarch Joint Venture. It's going to be posted on MinnesotaLive.com. You can support their efforts.